we'll hear from Carolina Franssen. We'll end with some really good news. Carolina will talk about how self-ID is no longer on the table in the Netherlands. Over to you, Carolina.
I think it's nothing short of a miracle that it happened in the Netherlands that we got self-ID from the table. I've been personally working on it for about 4 years now, and we have a very small group of feminists who are tweeting about it all the time, trying to reach the media, trying to reach politicians. We also made a big list of incidents that happened all around the world when self-ID was introduced there. And I think that I'll put it in the chat. I think that helped because they were saying there are only a few incidents, and that's why we can easily introduce self-ID here. Nothing the matter. Men don't abuse this kind of laws. And of course, we proved them wrong by this incident list. But I think the political spectrum changed a bit at the last elections. And more anti-immigration parties got more votes, and also the new social contract, a new party, got a lot of votes, and they proposed to take this self-ID law just off the table, don't discuss it anymore. And all the left-wing parties were really pissed off about it. They want it now. They wanted, you know, debate on self-ID. While before they just vilified us, and well, all the newspapers vilified us. If they even spoke about us, they also gave they gave transgenders all the place to speak their mind, and everybody in favor got, you know, all the media with them, and only we were hardly ever heard, only by special media, by alternative media. And I got on TV a few times only. I thought it would be, you know, after a year or two, they would invite me for major talk shows, but they didn't. So it's really a miracle that we achieved this goal. But I have to say, the outgoing minister doesn't want to execute the decision of the parliament. That's one problem we have. And we have also still a list of problems here in the Netherlands. And one thing is that the our gender clinics say the CAS report doesn't apply to us here in the Netherlands, and we do everything right, and we don't need to change giving puberty blockers to children. So we have a lot of work to do there to influence the gender clinics. Also, we still have, like they have had in Germany, a law that gives people the right to change their sex on their birth certificates, just with one visit to a psychotherapist who makes a paper for them that they are really transgender, whatever that is. So this law is still working in the Netherlands, and our next goal is of course to get that law off the table. Also, we have a problem with our Equal Rights Committee, because they see self-ID as already achieved in the Netherlands, and they gave when any man asks to be, you know, allowed to a female gym or a female sport, they get support from this Committee for Equal Rights. And the another problem is that there is our equal laws right bill is equals gender identity to sex. So when somebody says his gender identity is female, we have to treat him the same as a woman. So also our next efforts are going to be on turning this adaptation of the equal opportunities law to return that. And of course, I don't know if that's in other countries as well, but we have this plan for a bill to make conversion therapy a crime. And conversion therapy doesn't apply only to gay conversion therapy, but also to gender conversion therapy. And a clinician is obliged to see this gender identity as a real thing and to affirm it. So this is a law we don't want to go into effect. We are fighting that one. And of course, there's also a law coming into action about hate speech, a hate speech bill in which we cannot call a man anymore. So we are not really finished with our work in the Netherlands. We are just starting, and we hope we get a lot more women to join us in this fight. And well, we have a Let Women Speak event the 21st of May. We hope these new parties will also make a new law that says a woman is an adult human female, and we mean adult human female every time we use the word woman. Thank you very much.